What is up, guys? My name's iirix, and today I went out to the mailbox and saw these waiting for me. And this is a fantasy crate opening, unboxing. I mean, it's not a box, but I figured, you know, hey, I got other things in the mail. Let's go ahead and open them up for just for the hell of it, since they all came on the same day. So these first two are eBay auctions that I got, which were a steal. This is a Soren. Grim Nemesis. Oh, come on. There we go. So, yeah. Pretty good deals. And I'm always looking for good deals on eBay. So, you can see it's got no creases or nothing. It looks pretty nice to me. So, yeah, for those of you who don't know, it's 4 white black for a 6 loyalty Soren. Reveal the top card of your library and put that card into your hand. Each opponent loses life equal to its converted mana cost. It's plus 1. Minus X, Soren deals X damage to a creature or planeswalker and you gain X. And minus 9, put a number of 1 black vampire knight creature tokens with lifelink onto the battlefield equal to the highest life total among all players. So, got one of these for my white black token deck I'm working on. Taza, old Taza from the first Ravnica block. And then we got this one. This one's a lot more secure than that other one was. I don't want to just rip into it because I don't exactly remember everything I bought recently. I'm a collector. So, you know, I'm always looking for deals. I just kind of, come on. Let me get a peeky. Yeah, it's fine. Yeah. Oh, psh. It's got a pull tab. Whatever. It's all right. Come on. There we go. Yep. Interesting. The paper, probably packing slip. I'm not going to look at it yet. Just, empty. Just because I don't exactly remember what I bought. Oh, yes I do. Yes I do. There was a great auction. This came fast, actually. There was a great auction that ended just 3 days ago. And so, I put in a bid on it, got, okay, good, I was a little worried, concerned, he, like, taped up the cards, I got it for $30, free shipping, and, it's 30 rares and mythics from, come on, from previous sets, and so I figure 30 bucks. I mean, if it stays $30, I'll be amazed because it's a hell of a deal for 30 bucks. I didn't think I was going to get it for 30, but I did. And it's not like it's 30 random rares. Oh, good thing this is damaged because who cares about Aligned Hedron Network, right? It's not like it's 30 random rares. I knew what was coming. So, yeah, flipping through it, Aligned Hedron Network, there's 4 of them. Here's the reason I bought it. Right there. 6 Thought Knot Seers? I don't know what I'm going to do with 6, but, I mean, for 30 bucks, these are like $7 a piece right now, I think. 7 or maybe 8. So, I mean, 3 of them is $21. 4 of them is $28. That's what I was looking for, was a playset of these guys. So for $2 more, I got 2 more, plus, I mean, there's 10 cards right there, plus 20 other rares and mythics, you know. I'm pretty sure there are mythics in here. Yeah, there are at least 4 of them, I believe. So Thought Knot Seers. Archfiend of Depravity is $1 or $2, and I needed some of these. I got none of them. There's 4 From the Beyond. Havengold Lich is $4.50 when I checked. Might have changed a little bit, 4 or 5 bucks, but about $4.50 when I looked a few days ago at the auction. And these don't look that bad condition either, so I should have checked the Thought Knot Seers better, but these are like $9 for 2. Brandon Jar, who cares? Omnath. Should be another Omnath in here. Tamiyo's Journal. Zendikar Resurgent. There's the other Omnath. Conduit of Ruin. and sire stagnation. So yeah, I bought it because I was looking at it, and the only cards I cared about were these. Sire Stagnation, I mean, I'll use them, but I didn't care so much. I have none of these. I have no Thought Knot Seers. I have no Haven Gold Lich, and I have one Omnath. So, yeah, for $30, I mean, how do you say no, right? So, yeah, just wanted to share that with you guys, because I was pretty happy that I got lucky enough to win that auction. But anyway, on to the main point of this video. It's the Fantasy Crate opening for the month of August. And let's see if I can find that paper first. There we go. There's the packing slip. Don't look at that till the end. Let's see. So, to start out, there's a deck box. Ooh, of Liliana. My favorite planeswalker. Can't complain about that. And then we got some packs. There's 4 Eldritch Moon. A 5th Eldritch Moon, 6th Eldritch Moon, and, ooh, awesome, KMC Perfect Fits. I love these. My buddy bought Ultra Pro ones, and they work, they're fine, but, that is it. They're fine, you know, and they do the job. I just don't like them. I think KMCs are, just better, because the Ultra Pros don't quite go down all the way on the card, and so it kind of sticks out a little bit on the bottom, and it's rather annoying to me. If you have smaller kind of sleeves from a company, I can't think of one off the top of my head, but a company that doesn't exactly go and do the most roomy sleeves. Let's see, so deck box, Legion Dice Turndowns? What? Yeah, August. Huh. Okay, Legion Dice Turndown, and nope, I got, instead I got me some Perfect Fit sleeves. Hmm. So then it would be $24, $29, $35. These are $5. So, I mean, I'm not upset, just strange. Actually, I think this is already open, too. No, it's not. They're still in the package. I was like, if there's going to be like 80 in here, because there should be 100. If there's 80, then what the hell, man? But, yeah, anyway. So, honestly, I forgot what I was saying. Oh, whatever. Let's open some packs. So, like I usually do, I'm going to go through the commons real quick. I'll take a quick look at the uncommons and actually really look at the rare, unless it's garbage. So we got Savage Alliance, Nephalia Academy, Noose Constrictor. Oh, already starting off good, and an Emrakul. Oh, so nice. I need some of these too. 13 for a 13-13. Emrakul the Promised End costs 1 less to cast for each card type among cards in your graveyard. When you cast Emrakul, it's very important that you note that. A lot of people have been getting that wrong lately. When you cast these Eldrazis, you gain control of target opponent's turn. Target opponent during that player's turn. After that turn, that player takes an extra turn. Flying, trample, protection from instants. So, very nice. I needed some of those. So, we got Smoldering Werewolf. Behind it, a Midnight Scavengers that is foil. That's pretty cool. I always appreciate foil flip cards, but this is cool. I think my buddy literally just opened a foil Graph Rats yesterday, so I'll probably have to pester him for that so I can have the foil set there. But we shall see. I was looking at Emrakul. Very nice. So these five will be garbage now, right? Isn't that the rule of good pulls? Whoop. Okay, all right. Now, so we go through. First uncommon is Peace of Mind, Faith Unbroken, Gnarwood Dryad, and a Collective Brutality. dryads too. So one in a black, Escalate, discard a card, choose one or more, target opponent reveals his or hand, you may choose an instant or sorcery from it, and that player discards that card, or target creature gets -2/-2 until end of turn, or target opponent loses 2 life and you gain 2 life. It's not terrible. Then we got Ovenwald Captive. Yeah, that's not terrible. Collective Brutality. I mean, it's a sorcery. Let's pull out Savage Alliance because I like that one a lot. And Noose Constrictor. I like those cards quite a bit. Enters the battlefield. It deals 1 damage to each of up to 2 target creatures. When it flips. When it attacks, it deals 2 damage to target creature or player. Yeah, whatever. Okay. So. Got the cat over there misbehaving. Hey. Ruining all my videos. Alright. So we got Blood Mist. Mercurial Geist. I love drafting Mercurial Geist. It's so good. Spreading Flames. And Athalia, Heretic Cathar. 2 and a white for a 3/2 first strike. Creatures and non-basic lands. Your opponent's control enter the battlefield tapped. Very nice. I believe she's 5 at the moment. Then we got Grizzled Angler and a Voldoran Pariah. Nice. 3 black, black. I want a zombie token. I love these zombie tokens out of this set. 3 black, black for 3/3 flying. Sacrifice 3 of the creatures. Transform Voldoran Pariah and Madness triple black. Transforms into a 6/5 flying Eldrazi Vampire. Got a weird smudge there. I don't know if you can see it. No, it's not really registering on the camera. When this creature transforms into Abolisher of Bloodlines, target opponent sacrifices 3 creatures. I like the Voldoran Pariah a lot. It's pretty nice. Unfortunately, I don't think it'll ever really get played in any format other than draft and casual, some EDH. I plan on getting one in a couple EDH decks. But yeah, it doesn't seem... I don't think the Black-Red Vampires are good enough for Standard. Definitely not Modern. Not the Voldoran Pariah, anyway. I don't think that's ever going to be Modern playable. But then again, I don't know. I'm not a Modern player, so I just pretend. Peace of Mind. Nebelgast Herald is always good. Set that aside. Foul Emissary. And Imprisoned in the Moon. 2 and a blue. Enchant creature, land, or planeswalker. It becomes a colorless. It becomes a waste. It loses all abilities and becomes a waste. Midnight Scavengers. Ooh, and the Handware Battlements. Nice. Add colors to your pool. Red tap, target creature against haste on turn. 3 red red. If you both own and control this and Handware Garrison, you can transform them into Handware the Writhing Township, and it's the top half, so I mean you don't get to know about the rest. I'll try to remember. The other half is 3 mana for a 2/3 when attacks. You get 2 1/1 red human tokens attacking. The flipped over version, the combined version, is the same thing, but they're 3/2 Eldrazi tokens, I believe. Geist of the Lonely Vigil, Crop Sigil, Advanced Stitchwing, and a Collective Defiance. These packs are paying off nice. Amrakul's like 25, Thalia's 5, this is 6. The Collective Brutality, Hammer Battlements, a couple bucks, Imprisoned in the Moon, Voldoran Pariah, and Collective Brutality I don't think are really worth anything, but... You know, I'll still take them. I'm not upset. And it's not like I have none of the cards out of the set, you know, so it's whatever. I'll take them. 1 red red, escalate 1, choose one or more. Target player discards all the cards in his or her hand, then draws that many cards, or deals 4 damage to target creature, or 3 damage to target opponent. Then a Shrill Howler, a Plains, and a Spider token. I don't care about these uncommons. Alright, last pack. How great would it be if I got another Emrakul? I need to get 2, and now I have 1. I need 2 for my deck. But that's pushing my luck pretty far. Geist Fueled Scarecrow, Foul Emissary, Lashweed Lurker, and a Noosegraf Mob. 4 black black for 0/0, comes into play with 5 +1/+1 counters. When a player casts a spell, you remove a counter and get a 2/2 zombie on end of play. It's alright. Grizzled Angler, a Plains, and another zombie token. Cool. I like zombie tokens. I do like Lashweed Lurker. As far as the uncommons go, what else is in there? I didn't really pay attention. I just flipped through looking at the set symbol. Fogwalker. Yeah, yep. All right. So, that was the fantasy crate for August. I might as well just go ahead and do this while I'm rambling. I mean, it's a deck box. We don't know what they look like. Noisy plastic. So, yeah, that's the fantasy crate for August. It's $30 after what they charge and shipping. It's like $26 and $4 shipping, something like that. And, yeah, you get six packs and then two random other items. And then you always get more than 30 bucks worth, not based on what I just pulled. I mean, this is retails for like four, retails for five, six packs is about 24. So, you know, 35 bucks, even if my paper was wrong. But yeah, you always get at least a few bucks more than what you would have paid. And so you're trading the option of choice for value. And they have another package where you get less packs, but more stuff like this. I just like packs because I don't need a ton of deck boxes. I don't need a ton of these or dice or, you know. Yeah, the other one's 35, 36 bucks, I believe. And yeah, so I'll have the link for their website down in the description below. I know last month's was not impressive, and I was talking to somebody, a couple people, about last month, and it wasn't just me. A lot of people were not super impressed with last month's, but you know, it's how it goes. It's kind of a gamble, but anyway, I highly recommend it. So if you want to, if you're interested in that, go check it out. If you just want to see more stuff by me, go ahead, subscribe. I'd really appreciate that. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you all next time.